Welcome to Cohasset Open Studios 2020. It's now in its sixth year. This year, because of the COVID pandemic, artists are presenting their work in different formats. Some of the artists will be presenting in a video on 143 TV. Some will be actually having visitors into their studios, and all of the artists will be presenting on Facebook and Instagram. So we welcome you to this, and we'll be presenting some of the artists.
Hello, I am Susan Boswell, and I am the owner of Barefoot Rugs. Welcome to my studio. I'm very excited to show it to you. My husband built it. We just opened it. It is took us about 6 years to come this far, so come on in and take a look. So this is it. I have always been fascinated by rug hooking. It is steeped in our history and started becoming very popular in the 1800s. Our frugal settlers who needed something for their cold floors, they would cut up old clothes, take a bent nail for a hook, and hook little pieces of cloth, usually wool, through a burlap backing. And that is how they created rugs for their floor. I have always been attracted to fiber arts. There's something about working in yarn or twine or cloth or thread or anything that is made out of fibers I find very appealing. So today I use a punch needle, which is a modern adaptation of a tool invented in the 1800s. I work with a monk's cloth backing and pushing the needle all the way down, it creates a stitch on the other side. You can take it in many different levels. You can use yarn, you can use strips of wool, you can use twine, you can use embroidery floss or thread. And with creating one stitch at a time, it's likened to painting with wool. You can use many different fibers in rug hooking. Here we have some rug wool, we have some tweeds, we have Noro yarn, which knitters will recognize, ribbon, cording with some sparkles in it, and you can even use a t-shirt that you cut up. This is a rug of our dog Rufus in his favorite spot on the back porch, and he is also the driver in the car of my daughter's drawing. What I really like about rug hooking is its versatility. Here I've taken a drawing of my daughter's when she was a little girl and taken the pattern and the colors and transferred it onto this rug here. In this piece, you can see the many different yarns that are used, even a little bit of sparkle and different textures, different size loops. And then as you pan away from it, it starts to look like some familiar scenes that we see around Cohasset. My designs are inspired by landscapes or a group of colors, sometimes patterns that I see. Often a mood. I try to recreate that mood that I am feeling when I see these things, and do that by putting in different textiles or different patterning. I really look forward to a time when I can welcome you to my studio, I can show you my work, and we can talk about rug hooking, and perhaps you'd like to sign up for a class.
All of the artists presenting this year, 17 artists will be presenting their work. Some will be actually presenting in their studios, some by invitation. Some will be presenting via this video. We have three artists scheduled. And some will be presenting on Facebook and Instagram. And you can always go to the Cohasset Open Studios website, which is www.cohassetopenstudios.com. We're now going to visit the studio of Elise White, a landscape painter, mostly on canvas.
Hello and welcome to my studio. My name is Elise White. I'm a lifelong plein air painter, and I'd like you to come and see my studio through the arch and up the stairs. Thank you for coming. I've been working during the pandemic on a couple of series, and this series is from Flying with Margot Cheel over the North River and Duxbury Bay. And I explored a variety of wetlands from our trip. I call Pearl Necklace. There's the North River Bridge and all the pearls of these little big white boats. One of the things that astonished me was how vulnerable these homes were to the ocean. This ocean goes on and on all the way to Europe, and there's nothing to stop it except for this wetland, and it's our push and pull of gobbling up the wetlands for housing that makes us so vulnerable. Part of my field and wetland series. You can find a whole series on my website, elisewhitepainting.com. This I did here in Cohasset, and this was at the top of Turkey Hill in June when the grasses are so full of light that they look like a stained glass window. These paintings were a walk with my family in Vermont. This shows the sweep of the land. I farmed for 20 years, and I would always see the paintings while I was farming. And I'm grateful for the time now to explore these shapes and colors and a deeper meaning of a landscape. And here you see the individual grasses, which I just find unfathomable that you can build a landscape like this from grains of grass. And here are the individual grasses, and here the sweep of the land with the sky reflected in those grasses. And our friends, the cows going into the woods. This is my final painting in the series of an egret in the late afternoon at low tide. I just love the wetland grasses here and the mirror of the sky, the trees in the water. As I said, I'm a plein air painter. I go outdoors and I paint what's in front of me. One important thing that I do, because my work can be very abstract, is the horizon line. And for all of you artists who say, I will never be an artist because I can't draw a straight line, I always carry a ruler. The rest is observation. When you come back in the studio, it's all about synthesis of what you've seen on location. And so this is a good example of how I work.
Visiting the artist on the physical part of the tour, you'll be strolling down Main Street past the historic buildings in the village. But there is a lot to be visible on the website, and we hope you'll take advantage of that. Reminder that this tour takes place November 7th and 8th from 12 to 4. And all work, both in person and on the website of these artists, is available for purchase. And the artists are available for specific commissions as well. So we hope you enjoy this sixth annual Cohasset Open Studio. And now we're going to visit the studio of Nancy Condley, who is a printmaker here in town.
Hi, I'm Nancy Condley. I'm an artist who uses a lot of different materials, but I wanted to introduce you to my printing press, which is one of the ways that I work. I produce prints that are monoprints, one-of-a-kind, monotypes, and I'm going to show you the process, because I don't think most people have seen the process. So we're going to go over here. The artist gets ready to make a print. A couple of things. You've got to imagine, because we're not going to do the actual thing. But paper gets soaked in a little bit of water to open the fibers and receive the ink. When an artist makes a print, they use ink. And the ink is the consistency of toothpaste, like that, very sticky. You can use a spatula to work the ink. And a brayer, which rolls. And what we're going to do is roll the ink until it makes a sizzle sound, almost like bacon. Then we're going to take a plate, which is this, a big piece of acrylic or plexiglass, and we're going to put the ink from here on here. I'm going to transfer it back and forth like this. And then, the real high-tech part, Q-tip. Now, if I want different marks, I'm going to use a brush and just kind of feather . If I want an image, I can use a toothpick or a chopstick and draw. So we've got our image. It's a very simple image. Now we go to the press. We're going to lay the paper on top of the image, like so. Just set it lightly. I've got the turner over here. It's going to go through got not much of an image, just a little bit. I'm going to go back again. We're going to roll the press through again, a little tighter. Okay. More ink and a little bit more of the mark. So this is just quick, but I want to show you some of the effects that you can get. Okay. If I use a telephone book, I can press those natural materials and then take those plant parts nice and flat and go through the inking process and come up with something like this. It's almost like a photograph because you really see the veins in the leaves and the flowers. There's another kind of print that I love to do called a collagraph. You take the actual material, glue it to a sheet of cardboard, and then cover it with aluminum foil and tape. Burnish it with your hand so that the image stands out. Roll it up with ink, and then you can produce more than one. This one is the opposite of this. When you print and then you flip it over, you get a backwards image.
I took different weights of paper. I decided I could start sewing paper as well as gluing paper when I wanted to put a piece together. I would assemble it and it would become a collage. If I wanted to do a silver dollar, which is the image here and here and here, then I might use a piece of my friend Tom Narton's beautiful handmade paper and cut out the shapes and cover what I've got.
Well, thank you very much for watching one in what will be a series of programs presenting the artists here in Cohasset that are part of the Cohasset Open Studios. You can also visit our website, which is www.cohassetopenstudios.com. All of the artists are presented there, presenting their work. And remember that all of these works are for sale and make lovely gifts. And all of these artists are available for individual commission work as well. So thanks again, and stay tuned for future episodes.